do you ever read something in a magazine or a newspaper that makes you go, what in the hell? Like I read in Time magazine that the United States of America is the world's largest exporter of sperm. That's right, sperm, cum, jism, ball butter, homemade yogurt, spunk. Now somebody at Time magazine thought this was important enough information that they needed to share it with the world. They must have been right, because they certainly got my attention. I didn't know we exported anything anymore because I didn't know we made anything anymore. But I guess we're producing something more important than sofas and socks. We're helping populate the earth with even more funny-looking kids. You might have seen some of them mixed children in your own neighborhood with the kinky hair on one side and straight on the other. One brown eye, one blue eye, looking like a Malamute. Now wait a damn minute. You might be saying right now, and I feel you. You want to know why all this comes flying off to? Do I need to duck while I'm on vacation, say down in Anguilla? Or make sure my lady keeps her legs closed in San Tropez? Relax. It looks like all that strong American jism is making its way to willing vaginas, mostly in Australia and Canada. Although some of it is trickling down legs in Philippines, Vietnam, and Mexico. The Caribbean seems to be fairly safe right now. Still, if we're going to populate the 7 extra states Obama thinks we have, we'd better get busy. I must admit, the artificial insemination is the only thing I know less about than international politics. But I can still deduce as well as the next fool. Here's what I'm thinking. We've always been on mostly good terms with Canada and Australia. Never invaded the country as peacekeepers, fired a shot at them, and now I know why. Conflict with these two nations would be like civil war. You can't shoot him. He might be your brother. But from the looks of things, we ain't shooting black no more. Also, when I think Canada and Australia, I think white people. And since shooting your wad in a jar for fun and profit sounds like something white people like to do, it'd be only natural that these two countries are our two best customers. The Philippines? I don't know. Beats the shit out of me. All I can say is I've met enough Filipinos to know that they're crazy and want to be just like us. You know, American, with their own reality show. To be fair, I've only met one Filipino, but trust me, this bitch was crazy. So until I meet another one, 100% is 100% anyone's book. If I meet another Filipino and they're normal, I'll ask about the craving of Uncle Sam's nut butter. And if the answer's satisfactory, then possibly I'll make a reevaluation. Now, although we withdrew our troops from Vietnam decades ago, some of the troops didn't pull out in time, leaving many round-eyed American byproducts who would love to have a child that looks like them. Hence, the Vietnamese market. Mexico? Well, I don't know. Beats the shit out of me. Don't get me wrong. I'm truly grateful for all those hombres who swam the Rio Grande and started giving our poor, lonely, fat girls some loving. Not that I give a rat's ass about their chubby little love life, but if they're home riding Julio like a little brown pony, the buffet line at the Golden Corral moves along at a much faster clip. But why are we shooting our cum south of the border? When you look at the condition their country's in, you think more babies will be the last thing they need. Once more, now this is just a theory, but maybe, just maybe, those Chiquitas are thinking if they have a baby from an American donor, Democrats will mail them an American citizenship right before the next election.
This is ridiculous.
No, it ain't that far-fetched. I bet right now you're thinking, it could happen, man. You have to give it to those little scrap brown bastards, though. They are industrious. But how many more construction workers, dishwashers, and gardeners do we need here, sending the money back home to La Cucaracha? Wake up, America. They're invading our country from within. I know this sounds like something from an idiotic James Patterson novel, but paranoia is real popular right now, and I wanted to get in on some of that action myself. The Chinese are trying to poison our children with lead, too, by the way. The Time magazine article stated that a man could get paid as much as $500 per ejaculation, something that most guys gladly do for free, and can make $30,000 a year if he could produce good, thick jizz with strong swimming sperm. I swear I'm not making it up. When I thought of all the potential earnings I flung around with reckless abandon in my youth, it made me want to weep. There I was, young, dumb, and full of money. But reading further, I saw that you have to have a PhD to get that kind of dough. To get a lousy $60, you have to have at least a college education. I didn't realize you had to be educated to do this kind of work. I know complete idiots who have children. I bet you do too.
Seriously, right?
Unfortunately, they not only profile you by education, but by pens too. So to add that, with my credentials, my sperm will fetch about the same price as gasoline, $3.69 a gallon currently. I'd be all tucked out and still bouncing chicks. I'd be better off picking up tin cans from the side of the road. At least I'd have something left when I got home at night. So some childless couples, single women, and lesbians are seeking sperm boners, and the internet is making it more convenient for them to shop. A woman can pick her baby's daddy easier than deciding on which pair of shoes she wants this week. Except for lesbians, who only wear comfortable shoes. The mama wannabe enters a picture of her non-virile husband or, if he's repugnant, Brad Pitt, and the facial recognition software finds a donor that closest resembles her request. 9 months later, ta-da, she has something Angelina Jolie had to wait years for, a Caucasian baby. Look, the new mom exclaims to a friend, my baby Joy looks just like a little Brad Pitt. Her friend, who sprung for a much cheaper supply of my sperm, then says, well, my baby Elmer looks like a little peach pit, but I got such a good deal on him, I was able to buy these new shoes. Ain't they cute? You have to give to some women, they do know how to shop. Now, people who have a conscience, and I know some who actually do, may be disturbed by the social and moral implications created by single women and lesbians that choose to eliminate the father figure from their mail order baby's life. Granted, this does save a lot of men from being fathers on the run, but shouldn't Junior at least have a chance to grow up knowing his dad is a deadbeat? As crazy as the Muslims are, and they are some crazy son of a bitches, they do have the common sense to ban single mothers and lesbians from access to sperm. I bet when the lesbians made this lifestyle choice, they never dreamed this would be a problem. Anyway, even married women in Muslim countries must get their husband's approval. This makes sense too. Let's say Alibaba is watching CNN getting more and more pissed off, merely contemplating strapping on a bomb at this point, when wifey walks in and announces she's pregnant by an unknown man she's never met, thus pushing Ali over the edge into martyrdom. If a woman's hair sets these fools off, what's a batch of infidel jizz going to do? Ali wants to know that those little future terrorists playing like they're hijacking a plane out in the yard are his. Now, being part of a child's life never enters the equation for most sperm donors. Like that numbskull in Virginia who can claim over 70 offspring around the world and maybe as many as 140. Can you imagine the number of t-ball games he would have to attend? Since he's college educated, I guess he could figure out a way to consolidate and have a whole league made up of his own little acrobaters. But this is never going to be a problem because he said, I don't see them as my kids. And this guy was chosen as a donor because he was intelligent? But 140 children is nothing compared to a man in Britain who sired over 1,000 kids in 30 years. Now here the world is full of bastards and these morons are out there making more. Responsibility. They should just take this word out of the dictionary because no one knows its meaning anymore. With all these little half-brothers and sisters running around that don't know each other, did anyone consider they may meet and mate and create a second West Virginia? Who in the hell needs that? And what if one of these brainy PhDs strike it rich and one day a little stranger shows up at his doorstep with his hand out? Show me the money, Daddy. What if someone gets stuck with a defective child? You just can't return it for a refund minus shipping and handling. Just because a guy has sex with a jar doesn't mean it's not personal. Now, the largest sperm bank in the world is in, wait for it, California. Bet you didn't see that coming. Right now, there's an intellectual out in Berkeley with a PhD in medieval literature that's using all that education to shovel French fries into a sack. He's thinking, hey, I'm an educated man. Why don't I go down to the world's largest sperm bank and make a deposit and start making some real money?
I'm the man.
Not so fast there, my little learned liberal. Don't start sexually abusing yourself quite yet. One of your fellow Californians has been hard at work, fathering 15 children already by giving away fresh sperm for free. And that is why the economy sucks.